You think an Obama-Hillary Clinton ticket would be good in 2012?
Sure.
This is your chance to talk back. While Republicans are picking their ticket for the White House, and Democrats are pushing for a very different ticket in 2012, talking about a President Obama, Vice President Hillary Clinton ticket. So what do you think about that? In today's New York Times, Bill Keller has an opinion column where he says Hillary Clinton would bring a warmth and an enthusiasm to the Obama candidacy. And he writes this: number one, it does more to guarantee Obama's reelection than anything else the Democrats can do. Number two, it improves the chances that come next January, he's not going to be a lame duck with a gridlock Congress, but a rejuvenated president with a mandate and a Congress that may be a little less forbidding. And number three, I feel like David Letterman, it makes Hillary the party's heir apparent in 2012. And the former executive editor of the New York Times is not the first person to suggest Hillary Clinton should be on the ticket, but we wanted to hear from you. What do you think of an Obama-Clinton ticket? He used to run the New York Times, and he thinks that it's time for that woman and that man to be on a ticket together for 2012. Is it possible? Bill Keller is going to join me live to talk about what some of the possibilities are for 2012 and what others are calling a dream ticket. You've probably heard the rumors and the buzz, but now the former editor of the New York Times says it is time for what some are calling a Democratic dream team, Obama-Clinton 2012. If that sounds crazy to you, maybe not so much. Bill Keller joins me live now from New York. It's nice to see you. Thanks for doing this, Bill.
Thanks for inviting me.
Okay, so here's my question to you. For a lot of people, that sounds great. Can you weigh the pros and cons of this for me?
Well, you know, the problem is that three of the people that it doesn't sound great to are Barack Obama, Joe Biden, and Hillary Clinton.
I had a feeling you'd say that.
You know, Hillary Clinton, grew up a Methodist schoolgirl. She is not going to say no if Obama asks, I don't think. She's a dutiful, loyal person. Biden obviously will do what the president tells him. So the main obstacle in this is the president himself. But I don't think he much likes the idea. So I'm not predicting that it's going to happen. But I think this has been kicking around for more than a year on the blogosphere. Judging from my email inbox, several thousand people thought of it before I did.
But you write beautifully about it. I will say that. I read your column, and I want to actually read some of this for our viewers who are watching right now, because you say this isn't just about 2012. You say it's about beyond. If she can do in 2012 what Obama did in 2008, animate the feeling of historic possibility, the pair can lift some House and Senate candidates along with them. And then you go on to say that pretty much puts her in a sweet spot for 4 years down the pike.
That's correct. And one of the things that I talk to a lot of women. I live in a household full of women. And one of the things that you hear a lot about Hillary is it's not, obviously it would be exciting to have the first woman vice president, the first woman president. But the thing about Hillary is she's actually qualified to be president, leaving aside the firstness of it all. And there's something a little extra exciting about, you know, having the first woman president be somebody who earned it.
One thing I was interested when I read your column was that Hillary Clinton probably would never want to take second fiddle in the role of a vice presidential candidate to go and do all the battering on a campaign trail. But now that we have super PACs, there's someone else who can do that. So it might work out quite nicely for her.
That's right. That's one of the collateral effects of that Supreme Court decision allowing independent expenditures is that candidates can now outsource all the mudslinging. It's what Romney did in Iowa and pretty successfully demolished Gingrich's rise, and there's certainly no reason that the Democrats wouldn't do likewise, which would allow Hillary to, rather than playing the sort of traditional role of being the attack dog, to just keep to the high ground.
It is nice to see you, and you look well, my friend. You look well rested.
Thanks very much.
A new USA Today Gallup poll of 2012 swing states shows President Barack Obama neck and neck with his Republican competition. The poll was based on a dozen battleground states, including Florida, New Hampshire, Pennsylvania, and Virginia. As for the direction of the country, a 4-1 majority say they are not satisfied with the way things are going in the United States. 60% of swing state voters say their families would be better off 3 years ago before Obama's presidency. The same poll shows that an overwhelming number of Republicans are enthusiastic about the upcoming election. 59% say they are extremely or very enthusiastic, as opposed to just 48% of Democrats.
While Republicans go through the costly and painful process of choosing a candidate for president, Democrats can sit back and watch and cringe and sometimes chuckle. But is the Democratic ticket really set? A number of influential voices have made the case for a job swap of sorts, not President Obama and Vice President Biden, but Vice President Biden and Secretary of State Hillary Clinton. An Obama-Clinton ticket is exactly what a lot of voters expected after their hard-fought battle in 2008. And my next guest thinks it makes even more sense today. Robert Reich was Labor Secretary under President Clinton. He's now a professor of public policy at the University of California, Berkeley, and a very busy author, very busy blogger. Professor, nice to have you on the program. You say Mrs. Clinton would fire up the Democratic base. How so?
Well, I think she was. She's a proven campaigner. She is obviously sharp and intelligent. She has a huge following. The most recent Gallup poll showed that she and the president are the most respected woman and man in America, and this is for several years running right now. On top of that, she's done, I think, an exceptionally good job in foreign policy. Foreign policy is an area where the Obama administration has shined, and even though the economy is likely to be a little bit lackluster by Election Day, having Hillary Clinton on the ticket would enable the president to put forward his foreign policy successes a little bit more easily.
I know you make several
Randy,
points.
Well,
you make several points about this. I just want to go through one at a time here because each of them really is worth a discussion. You also suggest, as you just sort of started to talk about here, that it would divert voters' attention. Putting Hillary Clinton on the ticket would divert voters' attention from the struggling economy back to the global stage. And you think, obviously, that would be good for Democrats.
I do think it would be good for Democrats. Again, the foreign policy successes of the administration in terms of Al-Qaeda, getting rid of the head of Al-Qaeda, Libya, getting rid of Muammar Gaddafi, dealing with the Arab Spring in a very sophisticated way, and onward around the world. I mean, the world's problems are still with us, obviously, but the administration has done an exceedingly good job. Even Republicans admit that. Hillary Clinton would enable the administration to put that forward. The economy is probably not going to be all that good on Election Day.
And what about 2016? I mean, this could possibly set her up, right?
Yes, the Republicans have experienced in recent years, or at least in living memory, 12 years. I mean, they had Ronald Reagan and the first George Bush, but Democrats have not had 12 years running since FDR and Harry Truman. And when you have 12 years, you really can put your mark on the government. You certainly can have a very formative effect on the Supreme Court. And I think Hillary Clinton has a better shot at becoming president in 2016 than Joe Biden. And even at this early stage, it just simply makes a lot of sense. And a lot of Democrats are coming to the same conclusion.
Bring it on, says Mitt Romney, as the president kicks off his reelection campaign. His approval rating has hit an all-time low. Yesterday's Gallup daily tracking poll, bear in mind this is the daily tracking poll, it changes day to day, is at 43%. That's below Jimmy Carter's standing at this point in his presidency, earning Mr. Obama the worst job approval rating of any president in modern political history at this stage of the president's term.
You wrote a fascinating article a couple of days ago talking about something that you think President Obama might do that would help his reelection chances. Talk about it.
Not something that he might do, something I think he would be well advised to do, and that is to put Hillary Clinton on the ticket as his vice presidential nominee this year. I'm not going to predict that they're going to do it. There are a number of obstacles in the way. One of them's Barack Obama, one of them's Hillary Clinton, and another one is Joe Biden.
But other than those three,
other than those little
pretty
speed
likely.
Bumps,
yeah.
Look, it's the one thing I think that the Democrats could do to nearly guarantee Obama re-election. It would generate enough excitement that they might actually have some coattails and help out a little bit with the Senate and House. And it would position Hillary as the heir apparent for 2016, assuming she wants to run, which she'll be, young and vigorous enough to do. If she drops out then goes off and writes her memoirs or becomes a university president or runs an NGO for the next 4 years, other people are going to move in and start claiming that territory. Yeah. Governor Cuomo, for one.
Right.
I didn't invent this idea. It's been kicking around for well over a year.
But it's been tamped down many times.
It has. It's been, I mean, I know they're thinking about it because they have categorically dismissed it on the record. So that suggests that some thought went into it, and they're, you know, I think, inclined to dismiss it again. But yeah, I think they talk about it.
Hillary Clinton would help Barack Obama in Pennsylvania, in Ohio, in Michigan, in Wisconsin. I mean, she would help an awful lot.
Could Hillary Clinton on the ticket provide that extra 4 or 5% that might bring a couple of congressmen through and might give us a Democratic legislature again? Possibly.
And again, give the energy that Barack Obama had 4 years
ago. And doesn't have
that,
now.
That, Bill, he will not have.
Right. No, this is starting to look like a low-energy camp. There's not, you know, a lot of the people who were passionate about Obama, both because of who he is and because of what he stood for, have lost some of that passion. So it's starting to look like a very low testosterone
campaign. Wait a second. You don't know anybody who's passionate about Mitt Romney?
And Romney.
And Romney, right.
And those five guys who are standing behind
him. Yeah, they're five kids.
So when we were talking about this offset, some fascinating discussions came up. I mean, a lot of people are talking about Joe Biden already planning to run for president 4 years from now. Is that right?
And why shouldn't he?
Right.
He's been a successful vice president. The fact that he'll be 73 in 4 years, vigorous guy like Joe, 73, I don't think is an issue.
Mark? Have you heard this?
Yeah, I think he wants to definitely keep the option open. He'd be well positioned whether they win re-election or not. I think it's one of the big obstacles to even thinking about.
What about Hillary? Hillary thinking about running 4 years?
I think
from
so
now?
Too, but I don't think they'll both be in the race in 4 years. I think one of them will be, but not both of them.
Ed? You think Hillary will run 4 years from now?
I think right now she says no and she means it, but if she rests for a year or two and gets that adrenaline going, and vice president's a perfect place to rest, right? No question.
Oh, stop.
And just to refresh everybody's memory.
Oh, wait. Who works harder, vice president or secretary of state?
Yeah. Oh, no doubt.
No doubt.
Just to refresh everybody's memory, Hillary won the popular vote among Democrats in 2008. Remind me how many delegates Joe Biden got?
I think I made that point over and over again in 2008.
Well, she did, and you bring up a great point. Hillary Clinton, if Democrats had the Republican rules 4 years ago, Hillary would have won. Bill, most people forget the reason Hillary Clinton lost is because the 13 races after Super Tuesday were uncontested.
Mm-hmm. Right.
And the second they got their act back together and said, oh, wait, this is a long haul, they won. Mm-hmm. They won in Texas. Mm-hmm. They won in Ohio. They went to Pennsylvania and campaigned for 7 weeks, as you said, and Hillary won by double digits almost. I mean, she is, again, no knock against Joe Biden, she is a formidable candidate.
And she electrified.
I can think of two people who can recite all of those numbers that you just did. One is Hillary Clinton and the other one is Bill Clinton.
No, right. Fox News Alert, brand new polls out now showing the biggest lead any Republican candidate has posted against President Obama. According to Rasmussen reports, Mitt Romney now beats Mr. Obama by 6% in a head-to-head matchup.
Still, though, many wonder what could have been, what would have been if Clinton were president. Well, if new polls are any indication, the Democrats would be in much better shape heading into 2012. A new Time magazine poll finds that if Clinton ran for president against Republican Mitt Romney, she'd win by 17 points.
Secretary of State Hillary Clinton is the most popular national political figure, period. Take a look at this. The poll shows that 64% of responders say they either have a mostly or very favorable opinion of Secretary Clinton.
Some may be Democrats. Some may be Republicans. But that doesn't matter. Just like it didn't matter that day in the Situation Room. When I sat next to Bob Gates, a man who was George Bush's defense secretary, and Hillary Clinton, a woman who ran against me for president. All that mattered that day was the mission.
To Hillary Clinton, keep fighting for us.
TeamHillaryClinton.com.